Hello, and welcome to Sanity is Optional Series 2. I'm Ricky.
I'm Joby.
And we're here to be your hosts for the rest of this
visual
version
of verbal
vociferations.
On the show tonight,
the other news with me.
So it's always with me.
The all new Sanity is Optional Soapcom.
And the quiz with Matt.
Welcome to the Sanity is Optional News top story this week. Two senior judicial officials in Malawi have kicked up a stink this week by suggesting that farting in public should be made illegal. They say that people should go to the toilet when they feel like farting, and that by making it illegal, they are increasing a sense of public decency. Anyway, other officials say that the law will be impossible to enforce and that many people would protest that it takes away their human right to freedom to break wind in public. Also, a sign with no smoking, no walking on the grass and no farting on it would just look silly. A man from Belgium, Stefan Engels, has beaten the world record for number of marathons in a year. He completed 365 marathons inside 1 year and is currently in the running for the furthest run of the year as well. The 49-year-old confessed that as a child he had been told that he should avoid sport due to asthma, but he felt that clearing this hurdle in life has proved to everyone what people can achieve when they race through life having fun. The Catholic Church has given permission for Apple to make an app for the iPhone and iPod Touch to help Catholics with confession. It takes the user through the sacrament and it allows them to keep track of their sins. The Pope confessed that he was not overly keen to allow Apple to make the app, because it could have dumbed down religion and brought people further away from God. However, with the Bible already on the App Store, they decided to give it a go. And finally, as it is Valentine's Day, many people feel that it is time to propose to their beloved. However, some people want to make a big impression. One man got himself photographed on Google Street View with a sign saying, "Will you marry me?" while another man edited himself into Back to the Future with a saying, "Will you marry me?" Perhaps the wackiest, however, involved the longest game of Chinese whispers in the world. The message, "Will you marry me?" was passed down through the line until it reached his girlfriend, who nearly ruined the game by shouting out "Yes" at the top of her voice. Now, however, Toby is going to sing about something very close to his heart.
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Toby, the part of the show where Toby comes out and sings a silly song. While talking with Dr. Stapleton, Toby confronts one of his deepest fears.
Your father? Fascinating. So what you're saying is, if your lips left you...
Don't be too bad.
Why?
Because I love my lips.
This may be more serious than I thought. Toby, what do you see here?
It's a lip.
What about this one?
It's a lip.
And this?
It's a lip.
Toby, tell me about your childhood.
When I was just 2 years old, I left my lips out in the cold and they turned blue. What could I do?
They turned blue, what could you do?
They turned blue. On the day I got my tooth, I had to kiss my great aunt Ruth. She had a beard and it felt weird.
My, she had a beard and it felt weird?
She had a beard. Oof. 10 days after I turned eight, got my lips stuck in a gate. My friends all laughed, and I just stood there and waited till the fire department came and broke the lock with a crowbar, and I had to spend the next 6 weeks in lip rehab with this kid named Oscar, got stung by a bee right on the lip. We couldn't even talk till the fifth week. He only spoke Polish, and I only know 3 words in Polish, except for now I know 4, because Oscar taught me the word for lip. Usta.
Your friends all laughed. Usta. How do you spell that?
I don't know. They turned blue, what could I do? She had a big lip filled with my friends all laughed. Usta.
I'm confused.
I love my lips. Scooby dabba dee dabba dooby bow. Scooby dabba dooby bow. Scooby dabba dee dabba dooby dabba bow. Scooby dabba dee dabba dooby dabba dooby dabba bow. Scooby dabba dee dabba dooby dabba dooby dabba bow.
And that was Silly Songs with Toby. Watch this next time to hear Toby say,
"Have I ever told you how I feel about my nose?
Oh, look at the time!"
Oh, hey, Toby. How you doing?
Yeah, fine.
Why so sad? Anna reject you again?
Yeah. Yeah, I've been looking at this website. It's called blinddate.com.
What have you been looking at, Toby?
I just want to know what it's like to be on a real date.
Hi, guys. Got your dates yet?
Yeah, I'm meeting up with her tomorrow afternoon after school, down at a local cafe.
Hang on. It's funny, so am I.
Yeah, me too.
Same. I think we should all go together.
Oh. Okay.
Matt?
Yes?
What's your username?
Hornybeast123. What? What's yours?
Lipsmacker95. Should we go? Yeah, let's go.
Go.
Hey, where are you guys going?
Nah.
And now for the quiz. Question 1. Who was St. Valentine?
Was he a Roman martyr?
No one's really sure. There were several.
Doesn't he fly around in arrows into people's hearts?
No, Toby. That's Cupid. Anyway, question 2. What day is St. Valentine's Day?
The 14th of February.
Today, or if you're watching us after our videos have gone viral and we're now all over YouTube, several months ago.
31st of February.
Yeah, it's just the 14th. Question 3. What do people tend to do on Valentine's Day?
They give roses and chocolate to their beloved.
Each other.
Lovely. What kind of results come from Valentine's Day?
Happiness throughout their entire lives.
The shops spend loads of money and... we feel awfully
And finally, will Toby ever get a girlfriend?
No.
Have you no sex bomb 50 sent me another message the other day?
Yeah. And now, after magically analysing my results in what feels like only a few seconds, I can come to conclude that the winner is... no one. No, I'm joking, it's Ricky.
Sanity.